Mr. President, I know that the distinguished senator from Louisiana has a majority of votes in this body for the Keystone Pipeline, and that is a compliment to her hard work in getting, aside from a minority of votes to a majority of votes. I will not be one of them, as she knows, because I represent what is the view of my fellow constituents in Vermont. We feel that this pipeline is part of the unquenchable thirst for oil that's destroying our environment. We feel that construction is going to move forward unless and until we get a comprehensive national energy plan. And this pipeline won't lead us toward that. It leads us to an energy policy of the past. The tar sands require an energy-intensive process, complete with the pollutions and harmful emissions to get them out of the ground, to extract them, to refine them. I'm astounded by the fact that the first year of operation in the existing Keystone Pipeline, and that was built, as you recall, as the safest pipeline in history, when it was built just a few years ago in 2010, it has spilled 12 times in its first year of operation. That's more than any other pipeline in U.S. history. And the worrisome part about that is these tar sands are harder to clean up. Ask the communities along the Kalamazoo River in Michigan. It's cost more than $1 billion so far, $1 billion so far, to clean up a tar sand spill in 2010. And more than 4 years later, it's still a mess. And landowners continue to wait for help to restore their property. Now, I realize this will create jobs as it goes down, bypassing refineries in the Midwest. You'll head straight for the coast so the oil can be used in export markets, pumped on ships headed for China. Well, that may be good news for the Chinese. It's not good news for the American people who are stuck with the safety risks, the health challenges, future environmental disasters, and so forth. So I will not be among the majority who will vote for it today.